स्टूडेंट्स, इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी स्टडीड रिगार्डिंग द डेटा कोड एंड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ डिजिटल डेटा कम्युनिकेशन. इन डेटा कोड वी हैव स्टडीड द फर्स्ट कोड यूज्ड इन प्रैक्टिस इज मॉर्स कोड invented by Samuel E. Morse in the telegraphic department. Then we introduced the baud rate code, which is 5-bit code. Then we have studied ASCII code as a 7-bit code. And lastly, we have studied IPSIDIC code as a 8-bit code, which is popularly used in computer communication. By knowing the meaning of data code used in practice for the communication between the computer, today we will proceed to study the types of computer communication or types of digital data communication. There are two types of the digital data communications which are used in practice between the two computers. One is serial communication and second one is the parallel communication. Serial communication is the communication which is used for long distance communication between the two computers, provided that two computers are far away from each other. Two computers may be located at the remote places. Under such circumstances, serial communication is most popularly used, in which the data is transmitted in the form of a bit one after the another within allotted interval of time. In this case, LSB is transmitted first and at last MSB is going to be transmitted. It takes more time to transmit the data. It is also called as asynchronous type of communication. Whereas parallel communication between the two computers is used for a short distance communication, meaning thereby if the distance between two computers is very less, then parallel communication is most suitable, where entire data is transmitted once at a time parallelly. It is called as a synchronous communication. It requires less time to transmit the data between the two computers. If suppose long distance communication is there, serial communication is preferred. If the short distance communication is there, then parallel communication is preferred. We are going to study, student friends, today both the type of communication. Let us begin with serial communication. Long distance communication is made serially, in which each bit in the word is transmitted one after the another. As we are aware that digital data is a combination of the binary digit, that is a bit, that forms a word, that forms a sentence, that forms a text, that forms audio signal, that forms a video signal. Out of that combination of the word, each bit in the word is transmitted one after the another. The communication begins with the LSB, that is LSB is transmitted first and MSB at last within a fixed interval of time. This time interval is fixed. Within that fixed interval of time, entire data is to be transmitted, beginning with LSB and going to end with the MSB. The voltage level representing each bit appears on a single data line one after the other until entire word has been transmitted. Because digital data is represented in the form of the pulses, voltage level, each and every voltage level, that is the voltage level corresponds to 1, voltage level corresponds to 0, both are appearing on the single data line till the entire communication that takes place. Serial communication takes the more time to transmit the data than the parallel communication. By designing high speed logic, speed can be possible to increase. High speed designing by using VLSI technology, aspect of electronic integrated circuit, one can increase the speed of communication also. Dear students, in serial / asynchronous transmission, each data is accompanied by start and stop beat to indicate beginning and end of the transmission. Means in serial communication, it will begin with the start beat and it will end with the stop beat. When no information is to be transmitted, the computer output line is held high. That high level indicates that no transmission is going to be done. That indication of the aspect of high level signal making other computer to indicate that no communication is there, that signal we can call it as it is a mark signal. In a mark signal represents the binary level 1 at the beginning of serial communication, indicating that no transmission is possible. Whereas when transmission completes, its output line goes low, representing 0. That is known as the space signal. The mark signal is a start beat and space signal is a stop beat. Means these additional beats are necessary to be attached in case of asynchronous or serial communication. That maybe we can call it as the disadvantage of serial communication. Dear students, that's why it is, we are going to say that in serial or asynchronous transmission, each data is accompanied by start and stop beat to indicate beginning and end of transmission. When no information is transmitted, communication line is held high, that is binary 1, and it is referred as a mark signal. At the beginning of the word, start beat is transmitted, which may be 0 or low or space. The transmission from mark to space indicate beginning of transmission, and marks to makes to prepare the receiver to receive the preceding data. After this, actual data is transmitted. At the end of actual data, stop beat is included, which is again high signal, that is a mark. A requirement of extra start and stop beat is a disadvantage of serial transmission. Such a communication is known as serial communication. Dear students, it is represented here. Look it. At the beginning, communication line of computer is held high. This held high level signal, it is called as mark signal. When its output changes from mark to space, means it becomes low, then transmission begins. As long as communication line output of the computer is high, held high, no transmission, serial transmission, it is possible. When the communication line changes its status from mark to space, then communication begins, and thereafter actual data is going to be transmitted. So this is the actual data which is transmitted, and once the communication completes, again its output line goes to high, becomes mark, indicating that transmission is over. For next transmission to begin, again it has to go low, and again further data is going to be transmitted. To transmit this data is transmitted within allotted interval of time. Within a fixed time, data is transmitted one after the another, such a type of the communication, we can call it as it is the serial communication. Dear students, let me proceed with the meaning of parallel communication. In parallel communication, all bits are transmitted simultaneously. At a time, all bits are transmitted. The binary word is loaded into a register having flip-flop, one flip-flop for each bit. At the beginning, the binary word is loaded in the flip-flop. For each bit, one flip-flop is used. Suppose 8 bit is there, 8 flip-flop forms the 8 bit register. And there, the data is loaded. The output of each flip-flop are connected to the wire to carry it to receiver at a time. The receiver is also a register. Multiple parallel lines are used to transfer binary information. Parallel data transfer rate is fast. Parallel data communication is not practicable for long distance communication because complication of the network increases for long distance communication. That's why for long distance communication, serial communication is preferred, whereas for short distance communication, parallel communication is used. 8-bit parallel communication requires 8 parallel channels and becomes more complex for radio communication. In parallel or synchronous transmission, instead of using start and stop bit, here sync bit is used. In serial communication, start and stop bits, that is mark and space signal, are attached. Here, those bits are absent, but instead of that, sync bit is used. Sync bit is 2 8-bit word, and data is transmitted in multiple word block, which is represented here. Look at here. This is sync, this is sync. Both are 8-bit associated. So 2-bit sync is attached, indicating that to synchronize the transmission between two computers. After that, multi-word block is transmitted. Sync synchronizes the transmission and reception between the two computers. Each block of data may represent hundreds or even thousands of characters. Means the data will be represented in the form of hundreds and thousands of characters. The receiving device looks to sync and start receive continuously data sent in 8-bit word. Means this entire aspect is transmitted at a time. Out of that, receiving computer reads these two words first and synchronizes itself with the transmitting computer. Then multiple block of 100 or 1000 characters data is transmitted. After that, let us see what happens. At the end of the block ETX, at the end of the block ETB, ETX at the end of transmission is sent. After data has been recognized, there is a code associated with the ETB, that is a end of block, transmitting block. After that, there is an end of text transmission. These are sent. The receiving equipment looks to it and recognizes the end of transmission. At last, it is ETR, indicating that there is an end of transmission. It is a faster transmission than the serial communication. Do remember, all this block is transmitted once at a time. At first, receiving computer recognizes this. It itself gets synchronized with the transmitting computer. Then it receives the data After that, ETB, ETX, ETR, if those are received, it recognizes that the transmitting block is over, transmitting text is over, and even transmission is over. Till and until these bits are not received, it continues to receive the data from the transmitting computer. This communication is as like that of, we have studied the shift register in BSC part 2, 1. That is, the shift register is going to use to store the data temporarily, and it can send the data out also. In shift register, you can store the data serially, you can send the data serially, that is serially in, serial out. You can enter the data serially, you can send the data parallelly, that is serial in, parallel out. You can save the data parallelly, you can send the data serially. That is a PISO, parallel in, serial out. You can end the data, you can send the data parallelly, you can transmit the data parallel, is parallel in, parallel out. Like that, by using the shift register, if suppose there is serial data, it is there, it is sent to the shift register and then send it to the parallel in. So serial in, parallel out, or parallel in, serial out. Asynchronous communication is going to be converted into synchronous. Synchronous communication is going to be converted into the asynchronous one, and entire computer communication is made possible depending upon whether the two computers are very close. Parallel communication is successfully used if the two computers are at remote location. Serial communication is successfully used for that particular aspect. Dear students, in computer and digital equipment, data is transmitted parallelly, but in long distance communication, it is sent serially. For example, when data is to be transmitted from keyboard to processor, it is sent parallelly. When data is transmitted from processor to the printer, it is sent parallelly. So that is a short distance communication. If suppose computers are used in LAN, no doubt the data is sent parallelly. But if you are accessing the data from server, it is done serially. By using shift register, one can convert serial data into parallel and parallel data into serial, and can be used for the purpose of the communication. Dear students, this is all about the meaning of the serial and parallel communication. Dear students, to undergo successful communication, no doubt it may be serial communication or it may be a parallel communication. To make it successful communication, error should not be occurred during the communication. And if such any errors are occurred, those errors must be detected. Detected errors are going to be corrected, and that is done by using some protocols. And those aspects we are studying under the title Errors, Detection and Protocols in the next period.